Hi, this is Devin Lockett here at the Biomedrics Health Center with another holistic health tip. Well, actually, it's a little bit more than a holistic health tip. It's a life enhancement tip. Today, we're going to be talking about monatomic gold, also known as ORMIS. You know, when I was doing the research preparing for this video, I came to the conclusion that I will not be able to do this entire video without notes. There's just too much information. And although I have a lot of experience with monatomic gold, I can speak from my experience, but there's a lot of historical information that I have to provide you with. So forgive me as I refer to my notes as we go along. In ancient history, there are many references to the Anunnaki. The Anunnaki are mentioned in Sumerian texts, Persians, Akkadians, Assyrians, Babylonians, in both Greek and Roman mythology. And their descendants are called the Nephilim. The Nephilim are referred to in the Bible as a race of giants, giant people. And several cultures throughout the world refer to an ancient species or several ancient species of giant humanoids or hominids. The Native American tribes that are considered mound builders, is theorized that they built the mounds to bury the giants after they had killed them because the giants were eating people and they were kind of nasty to deal with. But the ancient stories around the Anunnaki, or the visitors from the planet Nibiru, as some believe they are, talk about them coming to Earth and landing in the Nile River Valley. And the reason that they landed there in particular is because that area was rich in monatomic gold. It is believed that they actually created human beings to be slaves to mine this gold, as it was needed some say that it was needed to protect the atmosphere of their home planet. Some believe that it has a lot of different properties that are transdimensional, and we're going to get into that in a minute. The ancient Egyptians had a name for monatomic gold. They called it mufkut, which basically means, what is it? And it is a substance that was eaten and used by pharaohs and priests in order to communicate with the gods. In the Christian Bible, the story survives of Moses, after having received the commandments from God, coming down and finding that the Israelites had created a golden calf and was worshiping it. Well, the calf historically was offensive because the calf represented the age of Taurus, and we were leaving the age of Taurus, and Moses was the prophet of the age of Aries, which is why the Hebrews, the older Hebrews, still blow the goat's horn. But in the story, Moses commanded the Israelites to burn the golden calf and grind it into a powder. Now, if you take gold and apply fire to it, then it doesn't become a powder. It actually melts, right? It becomes molten. So there's some conjecture, some speculation that mufkut or monatomic gold is what it was created through the destruction of this golden calf. But in the biblical story, Moses cast the powder upon the water and made the Israelites drink of it. And also it was mixed in bread, and the Israelites were made to eat it. And this is believed in old texts to have brought the Israelites closer to God. Throughout the ages, monatomic gold has had many names, such as mana, or like I said, mufkut, meaning what is it in ancient Egypt, the philosopher's stone. It is rumored to have been part of the contents or the entire contents of the Ark of the Covenant. It is also referred to as the bread of the presence when it's made with frankincense, which is interesting. Gold and frankincense together. It's called the food of the light body. In Greek mythology, it's also referred to as the golden fleece. In Soma, it's called the Elixir of Light, and it's also been associated with the Fountain of Youth, as well as being called Solomon's Gold and referred to in Asian cultures as Chi or Ki, and Indian culture as Prana. In ancient folklore, or in ancient historical documents, you judge for yourself, it's been known to have many mystical powers. It's been known to be an antenna between the physical world and the extra dimensions, or an extra dimensional antenna. Because gold is an excellent conductor of electricity, ingesting monatomic gold increases the conductivity of your neurons and enables you to have superconductive powers or to have an extrasensory perception experience or a connection to the outer world or to the spirit world. In the terms associated with quantum physics, monatomic gold has been associated with what we call superposition, where things can be in multiple locations simultaneously, which is also called quantum location, quantum coherence, non-locality, and entanglement. Many Native American tribes believe that ingesting gold or ingesting monatomic gold gave a person the ability to levitate. And it has been well documented that monatomic gold strengthens and brightens the aura. In more recent history, it was rediscovered by a farmer in Arizona named David Radius Hudson. David Hudson discovered this substance when he was trying to provide nutrients to his cotton fields. He noticed a white substance that was depositing in the soil. He didn't know what it was, and when he gathered it up, he found that it had some very strange properties. He found that when he exposed it to the sun, that it disappeared. And it didn't just like disintegrate. If he cooled the area down where it disappeared, it reappeared, and it reappeared in the same formation. So basically, exposing it to heat and light just made it disappear into another dimension and come back. There have also been tests on it using a very, very sensitive scale inside of a vacuum tube. In those experiments, the monatomic gold actually made the scale read in the negative numbers. Now, this is akin to levitation. Like I said, David Hudson renamed this substance ORME, Orbitally Rearranged Monatomic Elements. Interestingly enough, ORME also means Tree of Life in ancient Hebrew. If you want more information, I recommend you look up ORMUS, David Hudson, on YouTube. There are a lot of videos about him, and there's a movie called All the Gold You Can Eat. You should also look up the Alpha Learning Center in Switzerland. The president, Sean Adam, I believe he's shares the sixth highest recorded IQ in history, as well as the Mind Spa in Georgia. The periodic table of the elements has a particular classification of elements in a transition group, and they're called noble metals. I'm going to read this off from my notes. They include cobalt with an atomic number of 27. Remember, the atomic number is equal to the number of protons in the nucleus and also the number of electrons as well. Cobalt has an atomic number of 27, nickel 28, copper 29, ruthenium 44, rhodium 45, palladium 46, silver 47, osmium 76, iridium 77, platinum 78, and gold 79, as well as mercury with 80. The agricultural uses of ORMUS is that it helps plants and fruits and nuts and vegetables grow to about twice their normal size. Now, once again, before I start getting into the health benefits of ingesting monatomic gold or even colloidal gold, I have to stress that I am not a medical doctor, and nothing that you see or hear on BiomedRx TV or Devin Lockett TV, for that matter, should be construed as medical advice in any form. That having been said, the health benefits. First, let's talk about colloidal gold. Colloidal gold is not monatomic gold. Colloidal gold is actually nanoparticles of gold, but it's still in its metallic state. And some people like to ingest colloidal gold just like they like to ingest colloidal silver because of its antiviral and antibacterial qualities. But before we get into monatomic gold, I want to tell you about colloidal gold. Colloidal gold is known to reduce swelling and inflammation. It's also good in combating arthritis, tendonitis, bursitis, and rheumatism. Colloidal gold is known for neutralizing and balancing negative emotions like anger, anxiety, stress, and depression. By increasing the electrical conductivity in the blood and in the body, gold is one of the best conductors of electricity. It also increases the conductivity of your neurons. This improves brain function, cognitive function. It also improves the function of your glands. It cures chemical and hormonal imbalances and improves the function of the sexual organs. Now, when you're taking monatomic gold, you can take it in two different forms. You can take it in ethereum gold, which is naturally occurring. It's usually found on the floor of ancient seabeds. And you can also take what is called monatomic gold, which is manufactured ormus gold. Now remember, the monatomic gold has a lot of other elements in it, all of the other elements that are part of the ormus chart. Monatomic gold is usually manufactured from volcanic or seawater deposits. And sometimes it's made from metallic gold, from regular gold itself. Now I'm going to read off the many benefits of monatomic gold because there are too many for me to memorize and just speak into the camera. Monatomic gold promotes mental clarity. It improves focus and concentration. It's good for synchronization of the left and right hemisphere of the brain. Here at the Biometrics Health Center, we perform synchrony neural feedback at every frequency from delta to theta to alpha, beta, high beta, gamma, and even in the high gamma range, which is where I train. And I do find that it does improve your ability to do synchrony neural feedback more effectively. And I'm going to show the charts of that in future videos. I'm going to show the charts of my neural feedback sessions, my synchrony neurofeedback sessions with and without monatomic gold, so that you can see the comparison. It also increases alpha production, the production of alpha waves. Alpha waves are in the frequency around 10 hertz, or say 9 to 12 hertz, and that's the happiness frequency. It's also good for learning, and it boosts the IQ. It also reduces restlessness and fatigue. Because of its properties as a superconductor, monatomic gold also improves your intuition, your sense of intuition, I guess what they call the sixth sense, and your psychic abilities. Like I said before, it's an antenna to the extra-dimensional realm. It increases the production of HGH, human growth hormone, which of course makes you look beautiful and young, improves the elasticity of your skin. Is very good for your health overall, which improves your stamina, your energy, and gives you good deep sleep. Monatomic gold has been known to promote faster healing. There's a story out about a cat who had lost its tail, had its tail chopped off, but kept eating a hand cream that its owner had, which was infused with ormus. And suddenly, well, not suddenly, but over a period of time, the cat's tail regrew fully, as though the cat had never lost his tail. It fights chronic pain. It increases melanin production, which gives you your color back, and it also improves the quality of your skin, your fingernails, and hair. It turns gray hair back to its original color, be it brown, redhead, blonde, whatever you were when you were younger. It's been known to regrow teeth and also to get rid of bald spots, to help hair grow where bald spots once were. Without making an extraordinary claim, it's known to kind of reverse the aging process. I think that's why it's associated with the story of the Fountain of Youth. It improves concentration, memory, it expands your awareness, it's good for lucid dreaming, meditation, and prayer. Yes, prayer. It's considered food for the pineal gland. It repairs and supports your DNA, it cleans it up, and it helps to detoxify the body of heavy metals. It's good for maintaining overall health and weight management, and it raises your IQ and your sense of intuition and sensitivity and empathy for others. Like I said before, it acts as an antenna, an interdimensional antenna. So you're going to have lucid dreams, you're going to have very clear dreams, and you're going to be able to remember your dreams and interpret those dreams as premonitions to help you solve problems in your life. Now, this is just my personal advice on how to prepare for taking monatomic gold, because I think that this is something you should take seriously, and it's something that you should prepare yourself for. I believe it's good to cleanse your body, stop drinking alcohol, stop taking any drugs. I can't make any recommendations as far as your any medications that you may be on, but you stop smoking pot and stop drinking alcohol and doing whatever drugs you may be doing. You want to really be in tune with yourself, and I recommend you go through a period of fasting. Go through a nice long fast and cleanse your body out. Give yourself a chance to start clean. Also, it's a good idea to sauna. If you can do that, if you don't have any kind of heart condition that prevents you from sweating or, you know, taking the heat of the sauna. Like I've said on previous videos, you should stop using fluoridated toothpaste with fluoride in it, because fluoride tends to calcify the pineal gland, and monatomic gold is actually food for the pineal gland, also known as your third eye chakra. You should also avoid eating sugars and chocolates and other things that may negatively affect your energy, like caffeine. If you follow a spiritual tradition that empowers you to have the rite of reconciliation, like myself, like the Catholic Church, you should do that. You should confess and you should cleanse yourself. You should also atone with the people that you love. Make peace. Make peace with yourself, with the world, and with as many people as you can. And also make peace with your ancestors. It's very important to make peace with yourself and all of those that reside inside of you. Approach taking monatomic gold in the spirit of gratitude. And you should also write down your intentions before you take it. You should write your intentions down. What is it that you want? What is it you're trying to accomplish on a spiritual level and even on a material level? Monatomic gold increases your level of awareness, and so this also is going to alter or modify your thought patterns. Be ready for that, because this is a good thing. Increased consciousness and increased awareness is a good thing. Now, depending on how lost you were or how deluded you were, it may cause a little bit of anxiety. After you are accustomed to taking monatomic gold, you may want to graduate and move forward by working with a piece of moldavite, for example. Moldavite also has consciousness expansion properties, and it also has the ability to create coincidences in your life. And that is something that you're also going to find from taking monatomic gold. Coincidences do happen. If you don't already, you should develop some type of meditation practice to perform when you're taking monatomic gold. Myself, I come into the Biomedrics Health Center every day and train my brain in audiovisual and brain entrainment, cranial electrotherapy stimulation, and I follow that up with neurofeedback therapy, and that's my morning meditation before I get started. I think this is important. You should be ready to deal with the truth, and this is why it's important to center yourself with meditation from time to time. But with meditation on monatomic gold, you are sure to achieve a state of calmness, serenity, and peace. I also recommend that you add the use of Harataki. Harataki is good. I mentioned Harataki in a previous video. I think you can find it if you click right here. As well as DMSO. I did mention DMSO in a previous video, and I think you can find that if you click right here too. I think it's also good to experiment with binaural beats. I'm going to make a video about binaural beats in the near future, but you can also look up binaural beats here on YouTube and find a lot of videos of binaural beats, which are sounds that can help promote specific brain states or specific states of consciousness. Again, if you would like to have lucid dreams, I would suggest combining the use of monatomic gold with harataki and melatonin together, and you should also add a little bit of DMSO to that mix before you go to bed. While taking it, you shouldn't necessarily, you know, change your diet, you know, 100%, but I would avoid eating heavy foods, red meats, very starchy foods, things that are very heavy on the system. Definitely avoid a lot of sugars and coffee, caffeine, and chocolates. Well, that's all I have to say about monatomic gold for this video, and I'm sure it's been long enough. I'm going to be making more videos about monatomic gold and moldavite and harataki and the consciousness expanding substances and supplements that we use here at the Biomedrics Health Center. If you like this video, I'd like you to go ahead and hit the like button, share the video, and subscribe to BiomedRx TV as well as Devin Lockett here on YouTube. And if you would like to provide a little financial support so that we could make more of these videos, please become a patron on Patreon at patreon.com/BiomedRxTV and patreon.com/Devin Lockett. And as always, I would like everyone to stay kind, because kind is the new sexy. Stay blessed and stay healthy. Thank you for watching BiomedRx TV.